Hi, I'm Jenny Kilpla here at the Peter White Public Library, and we're starting a series called Community Conversations with PWPL. Today we're talking with Marquette City Mayor Jenna Smith about the Marquette City response to COVID-19. Hello, Mayor Smith.
Hi, Jenny. How are you today?
I'm good. How about you?
Pretty good.
Great. So the city has had kind of a multi-layered response as new developments are happening with COVID-19. But could you kind of give us a little, look back of how the response has been up until now?
Sure. So at this point, today is Friday, April 17th. All city buildings, facilities are currently closed to the public through April 30th, at least, unless that happens to get extended, we'll continue to reevaluate. We have closed beaches at this point, and we've had to make some other modifications, such as closing the marinas to be able to put boats in and those things. Those are difficult decisions that we made, but we did it in the effort of public safety and the safety of our staff. We do have many essential staff members still working and many staff members working from home right now. City government is still operating well. We do have trash still being picked up, water is still running, and when needed, the plows still run. Hopefully we're done with that for the season. But those services are also continuing as normal.
So how has that shift to virtual meetings and maybe remote work from the employees, how has that changed city business? Has anything been put on hold besides the marinas, like you mentioned?
You know, at this point, the city commission meetings being run via Zoom, the virtual meetings, it's gone really smoothly. I'm really appreciative to city staff for how well that they've managed that. And I think that we've been able to accomplish the city business that we need to virtually. I think it's a little difficult to kind of read other commissioners and understand maybe what their thoughts are when you're doing a Zoom meeting instead of in person. And we probably all experienced that lately with moving to a virtual setting. And we experienced that, I think, in our meeting this past Monday when we appointed another commissioner. And we were kind of deadlocked for 80 rounds of voting. But we were able to come to a decision, and I am happy that Commissioner Davis is going to be coming on board.
And I have to imagine that being an elected official right now, there's maybe even more you need to stay up to date with. So can you tell me what it's like right now being the mayor of a city during this time of COVID-19?
I would agree with that. It's something where I feel like I need to stay up to date what the national news is, the state news, local news, and make sure I'm informed and ready with the response and thinking about our residents and how we can help out. I will say, I know in this community and in all communities, residents really look to local leaders. They trust. I mean, hopefully some people trust me. So I really try to find accurate information, data, information from the CDC, and share that information out regularly, even if it's information people have heard before, just to reassure them that the important to share. And I hope that it's able to help, you know, keep people calm and keep people following the important guidelines that our governor and others have set for us.
And so you decided, well, that actually brings me to another question. How do you get all the information you get? I mean, are you talking with the health department and they're saying, look, there's a case in Marquette, or are you just seeing their daily numbers? How are you kind of being informed to make those decisions?
Many different methods, a lot of conversations. I will say I've talked more on the phone now than I have probably in my entire life. Here in 2020, I was starting to think a cell phone was just for email and text messages, right? But I have talked on the phone so much. So talking with a lot of strategic partners to do my daily updates, I usually go to the Marquette County Health Department website, and that's the most accurate up-to-date information for our county for the COVID-19 numbers. And then I also kind of check local news outlets. And a lot of times I'm on Facebook looking for some of those positive movements like the masks for Marquette or the Youper Makers United, some of those important community efforts going on to see if I can help promote any of those things that I feel like a lot of people want to find a way to help. So I look for those opportunities where I can.
And you do record a daily video update.
I do. I missed one on Monday night because we had a 5.5 hour meeting and it was midnight before I got home. So I just skipped one. But other than that, I've done every night.
Right. And so what made you decide to, record a video and post it to social media channels? It is 2020, so I think a lot has changed probably since the last major global incident like this. Why don't you speak to that?
Yeah, I think I hope that at least it's a little calming for people to kind of see a face and hear someone talk instead of just reading it on the screen. I feel like because we're not able to have those communications and see each other face to face or come to a meeting or go to an event and just happen to bump into each other and have a conversation, that video really gets across the human nature side of me and just, you know, my misspeaking and all. It's just, this is who I am. And I'm hoping that people are willing to bear with me and trust that I'm providing factual information and that I have their best interests at heart.
What do you think, speaking of which, you also instituted this Marquette moment, kind of asking people to go out and be on their porches, and then winter came back. I know we were on our porch, it was getting warmer, and that was really nice. So have you heard how that's going in the last week or so?
Yeah, I think it's still going on. I think I've had some mixed reviews. It's probably something that's difficult to sustain night after night because, you know, you look at the clock and you're making dinner at 6:30 and you forget and those kinds of things. But I do think with the warmer weather, it'll probably be a little easier. We'll be outside more often. And I encourage people to try to check in on neighbors, you know, from driveway to driveway saying hi, even if it's not that Marquette moment. It was just a nice way to kind of get people to see what they could do in a time when we all felt really restricted. So, if it fades away, that's all right. I think it's still a good idea, even if it doesn't happen right at that time every night. But you know, I've been trying to get out at least a few days a week at 6:30 and wave to my neighbors. We've got some neighbors down the street that their kids bike down the street every night at 6:30. So it's a pretty good indicator that we know, oh, okay, yep, 6:30, let's get out there. So, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, we've been eating and we've all dropped our forks. Come back inside.
Exactly.
So I know a question on a lot of people's minds are what are the next few weeks going to look like for Marquette or the next few months? I mean, on the city level, I'm sure there's discussions going on about what's going to happen in town as we start to go back to life outside of our homes again. Do you have any thoughts on that?
You know, the one thing I would say is that I think we need to just be prepared that it's going to be more gradual probably than we think. Obviously, it's going to be determined by our governor, Governor Whitmer. There's some national politics and state politics at play, which is a little interesting to watch. But I think we need to, in Marquette, do what's best for our community. And I think the more careful we can be and the smarter we can be, the better we're going to be in the long run. So following the important directives put forward by this, being smart, right? Trying to sanitize your hands and disinfect things when you touch them, even if things start to open back up, wearing a mask in public, some of those things are going to continue, I think, longer than a lot of us expect. And that's actually something that I'm going to try to get that message across in my nightly videos a little bit more and help people just come to terms with the fact that life as we know it or knew it before this, it's going to take a long time to get back to that. And I hope I'm wrong in that, but I think the more that we are mentally prepared for what actually is going to happen, the better off we're going to be.
Yeah. Yeah. I think that's probably the hardest thing for a lot of people is the unknown and just preparing yourself for what it will be. It's hard for all of us. Sure. You said you were talking to people about some of the good stories, the good news going on in town. Anything recent that you want to share? Anything you've heard?
There's a few that I think probably most people have heard about by now, but I'll just say the ones that I'm most familiar with. There's a Feed the Frontlines Marquette County going on where folks can either donate money or gift cards or food, if you maybe work or own a, work in a restaurant or own a restaurant, to the frontline employees. They've kind of got a list that they rotate through, which I think is fantastic. They that's on Facebook. Also on Facebook, there's a Masks for Marquette movement, and they are, I think they just have met their 10,000 masks goal, or they're close to it. And it sounds like they're considering continuing on, which is a lot of masks. That's a phenomenal effort. And then there's the Upper Makers United, where they're making kind of the face shields for healthcare workers. There's also the Community Foundation in Marquette County and the United Way have been doing some nice things to try to gather resources and information for people. So those are some good places people can start. I love seeing how people have been able to come together in a time when we do have to stay apart. It's amazing how innovative people can really be.
Yeah, in such a short time, truly. So is there anything that you want the city residents to know right now that I haven't asked?
I would just say that the city is, at this point, we are trying to look ahead and make those plans. We will communicate as we know what those changes will be, if there are any. If restrictions are lifted, or if whatever we need to do, we're looking ahead. We're trying to get ahead of this. The situation is fluid. It continues to change. And it, really safety is our most important goal for our residents. And then after that, just making sure whatever we can do to help our residents financially. I know some residents have trouble either with taxes, paying taxes, or their utility billing. And if you have issues with either of those pieces, just make sure to contact the appropriate department and we can work out a payment plan.
Okay. As part of this series, the library has been thinking about how we can help the community heal once we're able to come together again in whatever capacity that is. And recover from this crisis. And so we're wondering, and we're going to ask everybody what the library can do to help with that.
I would say what you've been doing is phenomenal. I really commend the work that you and your coworkers have been doing to step up and do virtual programming for students, for kids, for adults, keep them engaged, maybe distracted a little bit, which is probably a good thing right now. Encourage the arts and reading and some of those pieces. And as long as you can continue to be innovative like you have been, I think that's one of the best things you can do for our community. If I think of anything, or if anyone else thinks of anything, I'm sure we'll be sure to reach out. But I truly do appreciate all you've done. Even this series right now is a fantastic way to kind of connect the community to what's going on. Thank you.
Well, thank you. We really appreciate talking to you. And we hope that you'll be able to make those decisions in the coming days, and that you are able to get some rest having your own kids and working from home. I can only imagine.
Yeah, it's been a little busy, but you know, it's good. I've got, my husband is a temporarily, he's been staying home with the kids, and I'm working out of the basement here, and we're getting by, but as you know, it's busy, and but it's important that we stay connected and do what we can for Marquette.
Great. Okay. Well, that has been the conclusion of this community conversation. Peter White is going to host a few more in the following weeks. We're going to be covering telehealth. We're going to be covering local economics with the Lake Superior Community Partnership. So we welcome you to come back every Tuesday here on the library's website to hear more community conversations around COVID-19. Have a great day.